Hey folks, it's Jared Manninen from the website TahoeTrailGuide.com, bringing you a little different video today. This is day three of the Tahoe Blizzard of March, beginning of March here, 2024. And I guess this is more of a documentation purposes and see how it looks to live the mountain life video. Oh my God, I've been out since 9 a.m. It's about 3:30. I had an hour for lunch. Otherwise, it's been shoveling, shoveling, and more shoveling, mixed in with some snow blowing. Fortunately, my roommate is here, so she's been doing half the yard. Well, she did the driveway and then the front deck with the snow blower, and I took care of the garage roof, which it's mostly flat. And before the storm hit, I saw about a foot and a half of snow up there, and I was thinking, eh, I should probably get up there sooner rather than later. Well, it ended up being later, and moving roughly three and a half feet of snow off that thing this morning. But it cleaves off pretty easy because the heat from the garage just keeps that bottom layer from like freezing, so it actually adds a little bit of lubrication, that wet snow on the bottom, so it can just push over the side. But last year the side of the garage was literally, the snow was up to it, so I couldn't push it over the garage. I had to push it over to the edge of the garage and then throw it over the hump from all the other snow. But fortunately, I've only had to do the garage roof the one time, which it was today. And then, I don't know, we just have like a lot of square footage in my yard to shovel, because I like to keep the shed back here, which also is the storage spot for extra firewood. I like to keep that free and clear so we can get to the firewood, and then we have more firewood over there, which, you know, another big old pile of snow on top of that. We won't need it though. We're okay with the firewood that we do have out. But yeah, this is a pretty legitimate little tunnel. It probably would have been fun with as a kid to be playing back here. Usually I keep this section along the back side of the house. Usually I keep that free of snow, and I had been earlier in the season, but it just was overwhelming today, and it's okay. I just don't like it because the snow creeps up against the house. The yard kind of comes in at this angle, so I like to keep it from directly pushing up against the house, and then also just so that we have a walkway from that back deck, our sliding glass doors, and to the back door of the garage where I'm standing now. This little contraption, which hasn't been used at all, I pretty much set it up in case we have to use the generator in the winter. We had a couple of power outages yesterday, and we're considering putting the generator up, but when it's at night, it doesn't really matter so much because we're going to be sleeping soon anyway. And then I have one of those kind of lithium batteries that you can use for just plugging in a microwave or a lamp or whatever. So that's kind of the short-term power outage situation where we can at least get light and use some real simple... Oh boy, here comes another gust. God, it just hasn't stopped. I would estimate at this point, so it's Saturday at 3:30. This kind of started Friday late morning. I mean, if you watch my video of us, me and Dave skiing on Friday, it was pretty wet, graupel like snow, sleet, rain mix. So it wasn't really accumulating much on Friday until the night, and then, Thursday until the night, and then Friday, yesterday, it really started hitting hard. And that was when I was out skiing with Andy in the burn area, Angora burn area. And then today I just decided I'm not even gonna bother skiing today, because Andy did email me this morning and said he went out to do some skiing and he made about 1,000 yards, and he said he was so exhausted from pushing 3 feet of snow with his skis or whatever it ended up being overnight. So I just decided, you know what, this is enough exercise for one day, and we're gonna call it what it is. This sets us up for a big rest of our year though. We have lower temperatures, which is really cool, because That will mean that this snow will hold longer and may even freeze and, you know, act as a time release snowpack for the summer, which would be super great. So that, you know, it pushes that wildfire season back. But yeah, this is all set up for a lot of great spring skiing. And I'm pretty much, I think I'm at day 72 or 73. I think 72. So for me to get my 100 days of skiing in should not be a problem at this point, because there is so much snow now. And I'm at 6,500 feet, not truly lake level, which is closer to 6,230 or 6,229, whatever the natural rim is. I think it's 6,229, but I still consider where I'm at kind of lake level. At the same time, I live west of Lake Tahoe and I'm closer to the Sierra Crest, so we get a little bit more snow at my house than we would if we were in the city limits of South Lake Tahoe. So that's one reason why I'm able to ski from the house a lot more than if I lived in town, is because we do get a little bit more. The snow comes over that crest and starts dropping and then progressively drops less and less as it travels east. So on the east shore, it gets even less then. But it's all good. I think everyone's getting a lot of snow at this point. Anyway, I just want to kind of give a different perspective on the mountain living in the winter. And as cool as it is that I get to cross-country ski so much based on where I live, it also comes with days like this where you're pretty much stuck at the house all day long doing heavy lifting and manual labor like this. So it keeps me in shape for sure, but it definitely works me a little bit more than, you know, if I was just in the gym lifting weights. You know, oh my God, my abs are so sore from hoisting the snow and throwing it off to the side. Oh God, it almost kind of hurts to laugh. Anyway, like, subscribe, comment. Hope you guys are well. And like I said, I just want to kind of document some of this blizzard, this snowpocalypse that Tahoe's been getting this weekend. So here you go, watching a lot of me and Teresa shoveling and snow blowing and getting a pseudo view of my backyard, which is not much to show here. Just a lot of snow, but man, it's just giving me visions of last winter. And I'm glad this is the, I'm glad I haven't had to shovel like this very much this winter. So take care, folks.